On this edition of MC Gen Chem, Nuclear Structure and Radioactivity. All atoms have a positively charged nucleus and one or more negatively charged electrons moving around it. The nucleus is composed of two kinds of particles collectively known as nucleons. These two particles are protons, which have a positive charge, and neutrons, which have no charge. Atoms are arranged by the number of protons, neutrons, and electrons that it contains. The atomic number is the number of protons, and the mass number is the total number of nucleons, which are protons and neutrons. The number of protons equal the number of electrons. A general notation for an atom of an element is shown by the element symbol, the mass number, that is A, and the atomic number, that is Z. An example of this is carbon. Carbon's element symbol is C. Carbon's atomic number is 6, so 6 gets written to the bottom left, and carbon's mass number is 12, so 12 gets written to the top left. This notation shows that there are 6 protons, 6 electrons, and 6 neutrons. This is the correct notation for carbon. In any element, there can be variations in the number of neutrons, which leads to a different mass number. Atoms of the same element with different mass numbers are called isotopes. Sometimes, the nuclei of atoms are unstable. This leads to a process of radioactive decay. This is when the nucleus emits some atomic particles or energy, which is referred to as radiation. There are three types of radiation: alpha, beta, and gamma. An example of alpha decay of radium-226 is represented by the nuclear equation Ra goes to alpha plus Rn. In alpha decay, the atomic number decreases by 2 and the mass number decreases by 4. Therefore, 226 minus 4 is 222, and 88 minus 2 is 86, which is Rn on the periodic table. An example of beta decay of carbon-14 is represented by the nuclear equation C goes to beta plus N. In beta decay, the atomic number increases by 1 and the mass number stays the same. Therefore, the mass number stays 14 and the atomic number is 6 plus 1, which is 7, which is nitrogen on the periodic table. In this experiment, we will be looking at the beta decay of potassium. The purpose of this experiment is to determine whether or not a sample of an ionic compound is radioactive. To do this, you will be taking several measurements of the radioactivity of your material using a Geiger counter. Before beginning this experiment, write a null hypothesis. A null hypothesis is when you assume no difference between two or more samples. After all of your samples have been measured, a t-test will be used to determine whether or not there is a statistically significant difference between the means.